Perhaps it's too easy to be entertained by other people's misfortune, but the final sporting moments in our countdown are not simply about misfortune or bad luck. At times, there's real anger and malice at play here, and some very strong passions. And these stories got more votes than any other tonight, simply because they left such an indelible impression on you. Next up, a very bad night for Irish sport, the 15th of February, 1995.
Well, that night is etched in my memory, certainly. I had the dubious distinction of being the head of security that night. We had a lot of meetings with the Gardaí, with the English FA. We expected a small amount of, let's say, dubious fans to come from England. And we had, I would say, three or four times the amount of meetings and preparations and rehearsals than we would have had before any other match.
President Mary Robinson came out and she was booed by the English supporters, and I think there was a flicker in some people's heads, like, hang on, this isn't right, there's something going on here.
Now we're here for a match that is anything but a friendly in terms of the atmosphere. David Kelly...
There had been some tension before, we expected some kinds of incident, but we still expected a good sporting occasion.
A breeze whipping in across Lansdowne Road. The game is on and England playing in their away strip of all red.
England started off really well, Ireland came back at them, and it was really building up into you know, a fantastic atmosphere.
Here's Anderton, and the shot, Erwin, Kelly one on the box, Kelly!
And then David Kelly goes down and scores a perfectly good goal. I mean, we're going to hammer them.
That actually was the signal for the start of the riot in the 27th minute.
Trouble in the crowd. That's the West Stand in the Lansdowne Road Stadium, down by the Wanderers' position, pavilion rather. The referee has stopped the game because, well, he's actually telling them to hold on, or is he telling them to play on? There are guards on the pitch. There is trouble in the crowd.
A bad night is right. A sad night.
27 minutes of the match gone, and the players are being taken from the pitch.
It was the worst thing I think I've ever seen in sport in Ireland, you know.
And there you can see the missiles still being thrown.
It was started by people who had no interest in the game. They came over to be disruptive.
And that kind of supporter just isn't welcome in any kind of sporting arena.
I remember thinking, my family is sitting up in the West Stand. You know, my daughter, my wife, my sister, my nephews or whatever were sitting in the West Stand where this was happening.
After some minutes, I suggested to the president that we should retire. And she said, no, we'll hang in, as it were. She was very brave, or very political, I'm not sure.
I think the feeling at the time was, well, whatever happens, we'll be able to handle it. What transpired was they weren't able to handle it. They had no idea how to handle it, and it got totally out of control.
The rest of the ground are sitting there just totally disgusted by what's going on. Just absolutely disgusted by what's going on.
It was really orchestrated bloody violence on behalf of a core group of English supporters who we subsequently found out belonged to a loose alliance of individuals called Combat 18. I remember looking up at the stand and seeing all these Nazi salutes and these hands going into the air like that, and I'd never seen anything like that.
Well, that is a press photographer who has been struck by a missile.
When I turned and saw a bench, which was about 12 foot long, big piece of timber land on the crowd, I stood up and I said to my colleague, I'm not staying here.
I remember some very brave individual Gardaí and some security guys who were confronting what I described at the time, and I think it was still appropriate, this kind of subspecies of people who were just acting in animal-like behaviour and could not have cared less if they'd killed somebody that night.
I suppose if the guards deserve credit for one thing, it was that they prevented Irish fans from actually engaging with the English fans.
And there was very brave individual guys who kind of maintained a barrier there until the riot squad eventually came and half retrieved the situation.
Tussle about whose fault it was and where and what repercussions are of it.
The fact that there were only a couple of hundred involved probably saved the day, because in the end those people were corralled and they were diffused. Had there been any more, I think the situation could have been much worse.
We were very, very lucky to get away with it. As bad as it was very lucky that nobody was killed that night.
Time for our penultimate moment.